Hello, good morning. This is a particular session where we discuss the concept of head in a parabola curve canal. Okay? So here, what I mean to say to you is, you have a 30 meter vertical height. The vertical height is 30 meters. The length of this particular system is 2 kilometers, that is 2000 meters, and here the height of this thing is 30 meters. The vertical height is 30 meters. So 30 meters, 30 meters, 2000 meters, and 2000 meters. Okay, this is a box, this is a rectangle box. So you are cutting this rectangle box into half. Okay, so this is a right angle triangle and this is a right angle triangle. So in this right angle triangle, this particular section we will use it for construction of a parabola. So the length is 2000 meters, the vertical height from the ground level to the top is 30 meters max. So in this way, the parabola what we have to construct on this particular right angle triangle is coming like this. Okay, so this parabola will have a particular support called pillars. The pillar size gets reduced as the parabola comes down and down and down and touches the ground level. This is the ground level or the zero. So actually what you should understand from this particular diagram, from this particular picture, is the height what is coming from this particular area to this particular area. Okay, this particular area is the space we can utilize for construction of the canal. The dimension of this particular system becomes volatile if the construction of canal is coming from a particular section in the parabola. The parabola is like this. Okay, this is the parabola. The height is 30 meters. The distance is 2000 meters horizontally. This is horizontal distance, so this is the vertical distance, this is a parabola. Now to this parabola, what we have to do is, as we are taking the height as 30 meters and the length as 2000 meters, the parabola is having a 6 meter depth canal. So from the top 30th point, 30 meters, you have to remove 6 meters. So from 6 meters, a particular parabola is constructed. Okay, so in this 6 meters, we are keeping a canal. So this is how the canal is formed. So what happens is, when you are looking to the above picture, the parabola is having a space from the bottom side to the top side, minimum and maximum a space of 20 meters in this particular distance. So we can use this 20 meters for the construction of the canal walls, the construction of the canal wall. So in this way, the height of this particular system (6 meters) is a canal. So from 30 meters, 6 meters is taken out. So 24 meter is left off to this particular point, 24 meters. From 24 meters, we are making a particular canal. So these are all the pillars, and in this particular section, the pillars are there, and the complete section is filled with mud. Once the mud is filled, and the pillars are supporting this particular rooftop, this rooftop is concrete. On this rooftop, this canal will be having multiple sections. That is, one section is 100 meters, width is 10 meters, depth is 6 meters. So, in this way, 6000 meter cube volume is available. So the space available in one section is 6000 meter cube. So this parabolic canal, the canal is having 6 meter depth, linear position is there. I mean to say, entire canal from the starting, from this point to the end, 6 meters is the depth and 10 meters is the wide. So we are cutting the canal, bifurcating the canal into 20 different sectors. So in this way, 20 different sectors are formed, and each sector is having 6 meter depth, 6 meter depth, 6 meter depth, 6 meter depth. Likewise, the entire canal depth is 6 meters. And the entire canal width is 10 meters. The width is 10 meters. Entire canal width is 10 meters. And each sector is having a space of 6000 meter cube. So 6000 meter cube water will be stored in each section. So this particular section, once it is filled, the water will flow into the second section, and once the second section is filled, the water will be flowing into the third section. Likewise, section after section, the water is going to get filled and move forward. And once the water is coming to the final 20th section, the 20th section water will fall into the reservoir. This is the bottom side, you have a reservoir. The reservoir is constantly filled with water. And 24 into 7, all 365 days of the year, water is available. Water is available in the down portion of the reservoir of the canal, so that the pumps what we are using in this particular thing, the canal is having a particular system. This is the bottom side reservoir. The bottom side reservoir is having a pump house. The pump house will be pumping water to a reservoir on top of this particular sector. So the water will be constantly pumped. That is 6000 meter cube water is pumped in 10 seconds, 600 meter cube per second, and then the water is made to flow inside this canal. The water is slowly moved inside this canal. Sector 1 is filled, sector 2 is filled, sector 3 is filled. Likewise, all the 20 sectors will get filled. All the 20 sectors will get filled, taking a time of 10 seconds each. So in this way, the power is generated inside each sector. Each sector is having a particular dimension, that is, this particular depth is 6 meters, the width is 10 meters, the length is 100 meters. So in this, you are having a particular outlet of from this particular section 1 connected to section 2. So in this way, the section 1 will be having 600 meter cube is discharged per second into section 2. So in this discharge system, a bulb turbine, a bulb, BULB bulb, or tubular, TUBULAR, tubular turbine is placed in the path of the flowing water. The flowing water will be flowing from sector 1 through the opening and into the sector 2. So here power is generated. Power is P is equal to head into flow into gravity into efficiency is equal to KWH. So head is 6 meters. So head is 6 meters, flow is 600 meter cube per second, gravity 9.81, efficiency is max, we are taking down to the 60%. So we are generating 20 megawatts per sector. So 20 megawatts is generated per sector. In this way, in 20 sectors, totally there are 20 sectors, and each sector 20 megawatts. So total 400 megawatts are generated per hour. So in this way, the same water, what is coming inside sector 1, what is coming inside sector 1 and sector 2 and sector 3 and sector 20 is coming down and it is getting recycled. Water is never pumped from this place to this place. Water is never pumped from the ground to the top level of 2000 meters. Water is pumped only from this particular area to this particular area, that is maximum is 30 meter only. So this is a very important point for everyone to note. So water is pumped from 30 meters vertical height, that is water is pumped max to 30 meters vertical height from the suction to the discharge, and in the discharge you are having a particular system where the water is made to flow inside this reservoir. The reservoir is on top of 30 meters. So the reservoir depth is 6 meters. The reservoir depth is 6 meters. So as the 30 meter is cut off, only 24 meter is remaining. From 24 meter, the canal is channelized. This canal is there. So this canal is having a perfect gradient, a slope, and on this particular canal we are having sector wise pockets. In each sector 6000 meter cube volume is filled. So in this particular thing, the sector 1 will open up, a particular valve will open up, and 600 meter cube per second water is made to flow at 10 meters per second velocity. So the water is made to flow of this particular Venturi effect. This tube is Venturi. So the outlet of this particular sector is a Venturi. In this Venturi sector, the water is flowing out with 600 meter cube per second and 10 meters per second velocity, so that the bulb turbine or the tubular turbine or a turbine placed in the path of flowing water or running water will be rotated by the velocity of the water, which is having 10 meters per second and the volume is 600 meter cube per second, generating 20 megawatts per sector. So on the cascade, the head which is available in sector 1 is 6 meters, sector 2 is 6 meters, sector 3 is 6 meters, Likewise, sector 20th also 6 meters. The depth of the canal is entirely even. Wherever you take the measurement will show you 6 meters. The head described as in the engineering books is top surface of the water to the tail discharge. That is, if the section is there, the top surface of the water, the top surface of the water, top surface of the water to the tail discharge is called the head. Suppose if this is the turbine, to this particular sector, the angle which is coming from the top to the bottom till here, this is called the head. For a sector, sector 1. So, in this way, each sector is having 6000 meter cube volume. So, in this way, the head is even in each and every sector. That is 6 meters. The head is 6 meters because the depth of the canal is 6 meters. So, this you have to remember thoroughly. And where there is head, there is electricity, because water is flowing from a top sector to the bottom sector, because the area what is there, if you see the pillar size, the pillar is to the maximum length 24 meters. Second, the pillar length gets decreased. Third, it is still decreasing. Third, likewise, the pillars get decreased and the canal touches the ground sector, ground level. So, in this way, the head is there in each and every independent sectors as 6 meters max. So, this is how power generation is made by the flow of the water, but not of the fall. Fall in the sense, your water is lifted to 30 meters vertical height and the water takes a U-turn and hits the ground. So, here the amount of energy what is there in this tank is the amount of energy what is coming down. This is fall. But in flow, the flow is continuously taking place from point 1 to point 2, point A to point B is 2000 meters. But in sector wise, the sector 1 is having 6000 meter cube, a head is formed, then the tail discharge is collected inside sector 2. The head is formed, the tail discharge is collected in sector 3, the head is formed. Likewise, the storage of this particular reservoir is 6000 meter cube. So, once the reservoir is completely full, the depth of this particular system is 6 meters in depth and 10 meters width and 100 meter length. So, you are having even volume of water filled in each sector. 6000 meter cube, 6000 meter cube, 6000 meter cube. If 600 meter cube of water is released per second, then 10 seconds is the time frame for the sector 1 to get empty, and 10 seconds is the time frame for the sector 2 to get filled. So, in between 10 seconds is the time frame for the turbine to rotate and generate electricity. So, in this way, once the water is filled to the top sector, to the top side of this particular reservoir, then this water is constantly flowing inside this particular canal without any stop. So, thereby all 365 days the energy is generated, and the energy is generated in such a way that 140 megawatts is used for pumping, 144 megawatts is used for pumping, and 280 megawatts is used as sale per hour. So, this is how the energy is generated from the flowing water on a parabola canal. So you should understand one particular thing called head. Where there is head, there is energy. And when a canal is made, the canal is made in a horizontal length with even depth. The depth anywhere you take is 6 meters. So if you are leaving 600 meter cube into sector 2, then 600 meter cube should be going perfectly into sector 2. So the volume of sector 1 should definitely get collected in sector 2. So that is how the sectors are formed evenly. And evenly, when the head is there, head into discharge into gravity into efficiency will give you the power generation. And in this way, 400 megawatts is generated on this parabola canal. So parabola canal is a new subject in the engineering side. So this parabola canal can be used for power generation. So in this way, the existing canals, whatever the canals are there running in the country or any country, can have a second canal opposite to the existing canal. This is the existing canal. So opposite to the existing canal, you can have a 2000 meter long canal, man-made canal. In this canal, you can generate 280 megawatts every hour for sale. In this way, the entire length and breadth of the country, which is having hundreds and thousands of kilometers of canal running all over the country, from village to village and village to city and city to towns and elsewhere. So in this particular system, the water which is available inside the canal is stored inside this particular canal, and the energy coming out of this particular sector can be given to the local villages or local hamlets or local towns or local cities. And in this way, 24/7 electricity is available to every human being in every nook and corner. There is no tension for high tension lines. You don't have to put any high tension lines to connect from one village to another village or to one city to another city. You don't require dams, you don't require nuclear systems, you don't require solar or wind. In this way, the canal can support the water which is coming all 365 days, because with this energy, what we are doing is we are pumping back the water which is going inside the sea by the river which is flowing into the sea. At least Godavari is emptying at 100 TMC. For example, if Godavari is emptying 100 TMC in 3 months or 6 months of time, at least we can bring back 70 TMC of water back to the earth, back to the cities where we are living, back to the villages where we are growing our farm sector, and back to the towns. So in this way, the drinking water problem can be solved, the agriculture problem can be solved. In this way, the water which is going inside the sea or the ocean can be curtailed and made to flow back inside the areas where we require. So always the canals will be full, the dams which are getting emptied can be filled again. In this way, there is no requirement for the rainfall. Suppose if there is no rain for 2 or 3 years or 10 years, still then we can use this particular system by making excess amount of electricity and bringing back the water which is readily available at the outlets of the rivers which are joining the sea. So all the sectors which are there in India, for example, Brahmaputra is there, Ganges is there, likewise Alaknanda is there, likewise there are so many rivers which are flowing perennial. So if there is no rain in one state or one region, that is in South India, if there is no rain, water can be made to flow in the pipelines or in the canals, and thereby the connectivity of canals can bring greenery to this particular planet. Thereby the crops can be there for 3 times a year. The farmers can enjoy all 3 varieties of crops, whatever they want to put. They can cultivate paddy, they can cultivate millets, or they can cultivate wheat, or they can cultivate anything. So in this way, fisheries can be profitable, fisheries can grow, or sericulture can grow, or dairy sector can grow, because water is abundant in this particular thing. So my innovation is concentrating on dairy, agriculture, industry. Likewise, every sector, because every sector is requiring only one thing, the requirement is electricity. So I am concentrating on the generation part of electricity and water transportation. Electricity and water is my subject. So in this way, we can make each and every country self-sufficient by bringing green electricity and green age. Green age is coming, and green age is a very important factor for the stopping of global warming. In this way, I am doing my best for the green planet, for the earth, and for the human upliftment. Thank you.